Dear Agni Yogis, this broadcasting is addressed not only to the elderly who are already more than 80 years old and facing death, but to everyone, especially the youth. Few are aware. Your attitude towards death is of the utmost importance for the quality of your life today. If you regard yourself as an immortal spirit, living eternally, your present-day earthly life will be joyful. If, on the other hand, you are an old mortal man and expect your existence to be completely wiped out within the near or distant future, you will only lead a miserable life.
Denn solange du das nicht hast, dieses Stirb und Werde, bist du nur ein trüber Gast auf der dunklen Erde. Or, in English, for as long as you do not have this dying and growing, you are just a dull guest on a dark earth.
Since time's immemorial, all teachings of higher wisdom tell, and to you as an immortal applies even more. From the very first day, your whole life should be a preparation for the return to the supermundane world, your true homeland.
Poorly will live the one who does not know how to die properly.
If you want to die in dignity, you should know your true higher self is immortal and eternal. Furthermore, you should know how does the other world look like in which you will be living after the death of your body. What conditions are prevailing and what laws are governing there. Therefore, you should have watched our broadcastings, The Secret of Immortality, Death and Rebirth, and the Supermundane World. Without the basic knowledge conveyed there, we can hardly speak meaningfully about the right attitude towards dying. The attitude towards death reveals the level of the spiritual culture of a time. It is a shame how many people who call themselves Christians are filled with fear of death and thus reveal their lack of higher knowledge. Religion, as it is taught today, can neither bring them comfort nor help.
Fear of death is the weightiest self-judgment. Fear of death shuns growth and envies each one who welcomes a change of life. An indescribable terror is the fear of death. One cannot escape it. It is a freezing paralysis. Beware the fear of death.
The terrible misconception that death means the irrevocable end of our existence drives people into an abyss without a way out. It ruins exactly our best opportunities, unlimited evolution.
He who dies through his insistence that there is no life after death actually furnishes a typical example of the independent action of psychic energy. He practically commands himself to cease living and achieves the results of his command.
For you, as a spiritual being living eternally, there is no death in the sense of the complete extermination of your existence. This existential problem is solved by your accepting the law of rebirth. Then death loses its terror.
When the principle of infinity applies, there can be no limit to anything or anyone, neither to the universe as a whole, nor to you as an individual being. The yogi knows no death, for the awakened consciousness experiences no interruption of existence.
The death of the body serves only to enable the soul to free itself from old, obsolete forms and to create new, better ones.
We must die that life may have more perfect expression. One must accept all transitions as improvements.
The so-called death is only a transition to another state of being, the passing from one level to the other.
Crossing into the supermundane world is as easy as entering the next room. The existent is indestructible and manifold in its states. We do not die, but change. Can one speak any more clearly about eternal life?
Agni Yoga conveys words of Jesus that are not mentioned in the Bible. One of them is,
"You are used to fearing death because you were not taught about the passing into a better world."
Dying is a natural part of our eternal journey, as the saying goes.
You have already died countless times. And every time you have survived.
The step into the spiritual world is nothing special in itself. You take it every evening, namely when falling asleep. You spend almost half of your earthly life in the so-called realm of the dead, as sleep is the brother of death.
It is impossible to convince people of the naturalness of the change of existence. Death is no more than the sharing of the hair. In both cases, is matter cast off.
We had already said, the new immortal man walks a continuous, uninterrupted, eternal path through the most diverse material and non-material worlds, spheres, and levels of existence. Your future life in the world of the soul is just another stage of this infinite journey.
Only the concept of the oneness of the path will impel people to live in beauty and to depart this life as wayfarers, continuing their journey.
Your eternal individuality leaves the sphere of the coarse physical existence. It lays down its material vehicle, the body. It starts a new life in the world of the soul.
People call this death, but it really is birth. Strive to reach the understanding that the end is a beginning. Thus is infinity attained.
The soul returns to its homeland. For the spirit, it is indeed a relief to be freed from the prison of the body and be allowed to leave the earthly veil of tears, after all.
Life on earth then becomes a journey which the spirit undertakes in order to expand its knowledge and consciousness on this long and dangerous excursion into matter, and not vice versa. The spirit comes from above and returns there when he has fulfilled its task. In this sense, the longing of the spiritually developed people to return to the eternal homeland is understandable, since we are only temporary guests on earth, which can offer the spiritual man no earthly pleasures anymore, but only sacrifices, humiliations, suffering, and work.
You continue your labor, but only if you have done on earth work on spiritual goals, which you may resume in the world beyond.
If people could understand that for a pure and aspiring man, the very crossing into the subtle world is the highest joy, the highest exaltation, and a full joining in the beloved labor, then many would strive to attain this joyous and broadened state through a worthy life on earth. It is fortunate when one is so imbued with commitment to the good that when crossing to the supermundane world, one can immediately continue the labor of light.
You meet again your true relatives, your soulmates.
Farewell only means a new welcome. What about the dear ones? The higher you ascend, the better and closer you will see them.
True affinity of souls usually does not manifest itself on earth, but only in the other world.
All earthly bonds, spiritual and of the heart, are not only preserved in the subtle world, but even grow and become more refined. Nothing can separate souls bound by love.
those for whom you may have searched in vain during earthly life, your closest and best friends, will await and welcome you on the threshold.
A yogi enters the supermundane world consciously as a welcome and awaited guest. Great is the joy when one can enter these new conditions as if into a welcoming home, to find there all those for whom one has yearned, and to sigh with relief that one more earthly journey has been fulfilled.